For Ross County, this game represents nothing but the proverbial banana skin. They'll be expected to win, but Stirling Albion, the informed team in League 2, will come into this match with a lot of confidence and will want to cause an upset. The ball launched forward by Vigers. It's controlled by Hilton. He returns it to his captain, but he's lost out. And it's Roberts coming forward, looking for options. And he's found Docherty. First chance goes to the League 2 side here. Having a go at the county defence early on. Gravosti, and he's lost out to Docherty. Good pressure from the Beano's midfielder. It's Wilson, and that's taken an unfortunate touch off the referee Alan Muir, who pulls it back to a drop ball. Header won by McGeeky. Byrne tussling with Iacoviti and goes down and gets a free kick. It'll be Jack Leach to take. It's met by El Zabadi, but it's gone just over the bar. Here's Hilton, hesitates and passes it back to Vigers. Here comes Iacoviti, runs into trouble. It's back again to Vigers. Long ball into the box, and here's Shaw. And he's made it 1-0 to Ross County. Halfway through this first half. It was a long ball by Vigers. It was Stewart who nods it down. And Shaw volleys it into the back of the net. Tilson taking absolutely no prisoners there. And here's Stewart, and he's found Shaw. El Zabadi covering at the back. Stewart. Well, there were some early chances for Stirling Albion, but you kind of feel like it's all Ross County now. And here's Donaldson. He plays it long to Hilton. And he cuts it back into Stewart. A shot! And the referee's given a free kick to the Beanos. Well, it was all a bit of a stramash. Difficult to really say what happened. Laidlaw giving the shout that that ball was his. And that's a decent ball at the pitch too. And it's a penalty for Ross County. McGregor, Ferlin Hilton in the box. And it's a chance here for 2-0. Not how Stirling Albion wanted to start this second half. It's going to be Stewart to take it. It's 2-0. The Premiership side move further into the lead here. Benny is so close to saving that. The ball thrown long and high by Donaldson. And Mackay's gotten the end of it. But Benny gets down and collects. McGeeky. Roberts. That's a clever ball in behind the county defence. McGeechy gets across and it's Wilson. Well, it's not a header, it's ever going to trouble Laidlaw. Stewart dropping deep here. It's a sumptuous ball through to Mackay. Comes close to making it three. Just fizzes past the post. And there's Reid. He gets the ball back. He's hit the post. Plays a lovely 1-2 here with Hilton. And the young defender from Dingwall, I'm sure, would have loved to have scored here. They would have enjoyed it too. Wilson managing to keep the ball for Stirling there. That's a nice ball through to Byrne. Not the best of crosses. Stewart. Figers. Here's Gravosti, who finds Charles Cook, the former Arsenal youth player, and he's made it three. 71 minutes on the clock. Well, he cuts inside and with his left foot just finds a gap. Stirling Albion maybe just looking for a consolation now. Laidlaw has to deal with the corner. Banner trying to get out of the corner. And he finds Wilson. Turns inside and feeds it to Leach. Now Ross County can get the ball away. Here's an opportunity now for Hilton, and Benny slips but makes a save. It was a good recovery from Cammy Benny to make that save. County on the hunt here for a fourth. That's gone straight to Charles Cook, and in the end comes off his own player. Ross County have been playing some nice balls in behind all day, and this is Reid again. He ran all the way from defence once again, and Benny had to be alert. And Mackin to Heaver. That's collected by Laidlaw. Ross County just taking their time. They don't need to be in any rush. And that's a lovely ball to right. And it's off the bar. The 18-year-old from Stornoway could have scored in his home debut. Figers. And in the end, it's as you might expect, with the Premiership side winning 3-0. Ross County through to the last 16.
Kevin, your thoughts after today's game?
Difficult day, you know, I think we acquitted ourselves well, you know, and we represented ourselves well. So overall, you know, I've got to go away and be proud of the effort and desire and enthusiasm of the players to take on which turned out to be, you know, a very formidable opponent in Ross County, and you know, they moved the ball. Great credit to the work that's been done there. They moved the ball about well. You know, they stretched us. They stuck to their game plan, as did we. And you know, maybe a wee bit of naivety over the three goals, you know, which we can look at and dissect. But overall, you know, the better team in the day won. But what an experience! And you know, we've all thoroughly enjoyed it.
It was always going to be a tough task, but it's a good experience for the players to come up here and play against a higher opposition.
Yep, definitely. You know, there's a bravery is a word used in football, you know, and we often link it with tackles and headers, but bravery today was making a pass and getting yourself in the ball. And I thought to a man, I thought my players tried to do that. You know, they didn't revert to long ball. You know, they tried to play, and that's brave. You know, taking the ball when you know you've got, you know, good players around you and pressing you and putting you under pressure. So that was a huge positive for me today, that we stuck to it, that we stuck to what we believe in. And we're going to keep trying to do that. You know, obviously different games present different problems. Today presented a few more than we've been used to. But overall, you know, as I say, I'm delighted with the application. There's an obvious disappointment with the result, but as I say, that's up to us to dissect. But no hangover. We must move on quickly and prepare for what's a big game next week against Elgin.
Coming up against SPL opposition, it's always got to be a hard task for us, but we came up with a game plan. We stuck to it for 45 minutes, I would say. And then obviously the penalty kind of kills that wee bit, but apart from that, it was a good test, good for the fitness levels, and we just look forward to the league next week.